Our top story this evening, the UN Security Council has imposed sanctions on 4 North Korean companies and 14 officials, adding to the pressure on Pyongyang over its repeated ballistic missile launches. The Council voted unanimously to support measures jointly proposed by the United States and China. Kim Jong-soo starts us off.
6 months after the previous resolution, which was ratified in November of last year in response to North Korea's 5th nuclear test 2 months prior, the UN Security Council has agreed on a new resolution drafted by the United States after weeks of negotiations with China.
Security Council is sending a clear message to North Korea today. Stop firing ballistic missiles or face the consequences. It is long past time for North Korea to see the writing on the wall.
Over the past 6 months, North Korea has conducted more than 10 missile tests, threatening its immediate neighbors as well as the new Trump administration. Unlike previous resolutions, the one passed on Friday does not introduce new measures, reflecting that the Trump administration is for now taking a more patient approach. For instance, Resolution 2270, passed in March of 2016, enforced new and powerful measures including a ban on the regime's coal exports and mandatory inspections on cargo leaving and entering North Korea. But for Resolution 2356, adopted on Friday, the Security Council opted to add 14 officials and 4 entities to its existing list. That surprised pundits who thought the Council might decide on a resolution that would deal a more decisive blow to the regime's nuclear program, such as cutting off oil supplies. The newest entities include Korea Bank, which handles overseas transactions for North Korean officials, and the Strategic Rocket Force of the Korean People's Army. The updated list now includes 53 individuals and 46 entities, all of which are subject to travel bans and asset freezes. Taking a carrot-and-stick approach, the U.S. ambassador to the U.N. said the international community is willing to engage in dialogue with Pyongyang under certain conditions.
We want a negotiated solution, but North Korea must fulfill its basic obligations by first stopping all ballistic missile launches and nuclear weapons testing, and taking concrete steps towards getting rid of its nuclear weapons program. Our goal is not regime change.
South Korea's foreign ministry has also expressed its support for the new resolution. It said the international community will continue to press North Korea to abandon its nuclear weapons program. Kim Jong-soo, Arirang News.